the five exoplanets that humanity could move into in the future. When we talk about exoplanets, we mean planets that orbit other stars than our Sun. We currently have records of hundreds of exoplanets in different stars in the galaxy, but is there an exoplanet that resembles the Earth? And if so, how many exoplanets are eligible to host the human race in the future? Stay tuned to find out. When was the first time an exoplanet was detected? The first time exoplanets were detected revolving around the star occurred in 1995, and the scientists who made this possible were Swiss astronomers Didier Queloz and Michael Mayer, who observed an exoplanet orbiting the star 51 Pegasi, which is a star quite similar to our Sun and is located 50 light-years from Earth. This remarkable feat was a coincidence, possibly a eureka, as they looked for a small star orbiting around 51 Pegasi. Still, the method in question was so sensitive that it allowed them to observe this much smaller celestial body. How were the first exoplanets observed? The satellite that was decisive in searching for Earth-type exoplanets is the famous Kepler telescope, named after Johannes Kepler. This astronomer found the three laws of planetary motion in the 17th century. The satellite was put into orbit by NASA in 2009 and soon began reporting exoplanets discovered by the transit method. It had a 95 million pixel digital camera that allowed it to simultaneously measure the brightness of around 145,000 stars from a vast region of the sky that includes parts of the constellations Cygnus, Lyra, and Draco. How can we observe so many exoplanets at the same time? To carry out this task, we have TESS, for its acronym, Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite. It began its operations in 2018 to discover minor planets orbiting bright stars throughout the night sky. Like the Kepler Space Telescope, TESS identifies exoplanets by observing minor variations in a star's brightness caused by an orbiting planet. Unlike Kepler, which focused on a particular space of stars, TESS makes a comprehensive study covering almost the entire sky. Thanks to this, the chances of finding more and more exoplanets increase considerably. During the first 2 years, TESS monitored more than 200,000 stars shortlisted by astronomers and managed to detect more than 1,900 exoplanet candidates. In July 2020, TESS began its first extended mission. It continues to monitor our stellar neighborhood and identify the planets that reside in it. Thanks to this, today we know that every star in the Milky Way has at least one planet orbiting around it. Which exoplanets are potentially habitable? First of all, we must emphasize that there is an extensive catalog of exoplanets studied by NASA and many others in the process of selection, but mainly the exoplanets of which more have been spoken, it is because of their similar characteristics or potentially similar to our planet Earth. This does not mean that it is something sure. More studies would be needed to affirm that we could inhabit them, but the possibility is there. Among the most prominent exoplanets as potentially habitable is the exoplanetary system TRAPPIST-1. The exoplanet in question is TRAPPIST-1F. We can also find TOI-700D, Teegarden C, Kepler-1649C, and Kepler-186F, the first habitable exoplanet detected. Number 1. TRAPPIST-1E. TRAPPIST-1E is a terrestrial exoplanet orbiting an M-type star. Its mass is 0.692 Earths. It takes 6.1 days to complete an orbit, and it is 0.02925 AU from its star. That is, it is much closer to its star than Mercury is to the Sun. Its discovery was announced in 2017. One of the biggest reasons why the exoplanet TRAPPIST-1E is chosen over the others in its solar system is that its core is estimated to be very large, almost a third of the radius of the planet, compared to the Earth that has a core that represents 55% of the radius of the planet. The exoplanet's core can be compared to that of the Earth because it was concluded that it must be very dense. This means that if it has a massive core like the Earth, it means that on its surface there must be a geothermal activity, which would provide minerals and nutrients for the growth of microorganisms, in addition to the fact that it could also possess a magnetic field that protects it from solar radiation. In case we could travel to the TRAPPIST-1 exoplanetary system, we must consider that it is 39 light-years from Earth. So to get there, it would take us approximately 39 years of travel, if at the speed of light. However, unfortunately, there is still no spaceship that can do this. The fastest spaceship we have would take more than 500,000 years to reach this exoplanet. Number 2. Exoplanet TOI-700D. TOI-700D is a terrestrial exoplanet orbiting an M-type star. Its mass is 1.57 Earths. It takes 37.4 days to complete an orbit, and it is 0.1633 AU from its star. Its discovery was announced in 2020. Future missions could identify whether the planets in the TOI-700 system have atmospheres, and if so, even determine their compositions. While the exact conditions in TOI-700D are currently unknown, scientists can use the information they already have, such as the size of the planet and the type of star it orbits, to generate computer models and make predictions. Researchers at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, modeled 20 potential environments of TOI-700D to assess whether any version would result in temperatures and surface pressures suitable for habitability. Their climate models examined various surface types and atmospheric compositions associated with what scientists consider potentially habitable worlds. Thus, one of the simulations resulted in a TOI-700D with an ocean and a dense atmosphere dominated by carbon dioxide, very similar to what Mars was like in the past, according to scientists. The model atmosphere contains a deep layer of clouds on the side facing its star. Another model depicts TOI-700D as a cloudless version of modern Earth, where winds flow from the planet's night side and converge at the point directly in front of the star. Those two simulations have resulted in scenarios of the planet where it can host liquid water, giving us hope that it could be the future home of the human race. Number 3. Exoplanet Teegarden B. Teegarden B is a terrestrial-type super-exoplanet orbiting an M-type star. Its mass is 1.05 Earths. It takes 4.9 days to complete an orbit, and it is 0.0252 AU from its star. Its discovery was announced in 2019. Teegarden B is the innermost planet. It has a 60% chance of having a temperate surface environment between 0 degrees and 50 degrees Celsius, and possibly closer to 28 degrees Celsius. The distance this exoplanet is from us is about 12 light years. The exoplanet Teegarden B is one of the first to be detected with the radial velocity method around an ultra-cold dwarf. This planet has a rocky composition. Under all these conditions, it is highly likely to contain liquid water, which is essential if we want to move there in the future. Number 4. Kepler 1649c. Scientists discovered this planet, Kepler 1649c, by reviewing ancient Kepler observations removed in 2018. While previous searches with a computer algorithm misidentified it, researchers who reviewed Kepler's data took a second look at the signature and recognized it as a planet. Of all the exoplanets found by Kepler, this distant world, located 300 light-years from Earth, is the most similar to Earth in size and temperature currently known. This newly revealed world is only 1.06 times larger than our planet. In addition, the amount of starlight it receives from its host star is 75% of the amount of light Earth receives from our Sun, which means that the exoplanet's temperature may also be similar to that of our planet. The only problem is that the exoplanet Kepler 1649c orbits a red dwarf. This type of star is known for starbursts that can make a planet's environment a challenge for any potential life. Kepler 1649c orbits its diminutive red dwarf star so close that 1 year on Kepler 1649c equals only 19.5 Earth days. If humanity moves to this planet one day, we will feel that the years fly by, literally. Number 5. Kepler 186f. Kepler 186f is the first exoplanet discovered to orbit a star in the habitable zone, a region of the solar system where a planet can host liquid water, meaning it is not too close for water to evaporate, nor too far for it to freeze. The discovery of Kepler 186f confirms that Earth-sized planets exist in the habitable zones of other stars and signals a significant step closer to finding an Earth-like world, our next home. Kepler 186f's size is known to be less than 10% larger than Earth, but its mass composition and density are unknown. Previous research suggests that a planet the size of Kepler 186f is likely rocky. Before this discovery, the record holder for the most Earth-like planet went to Kepler 62f, which is 40% larger than Earth's size and orbits in its star's habitable zone. Kepler-186f orbits its star once every 130 days and receives one-third of the energy Earth receives from the Sun, placing it near the habitable zone's outer edge. If you could stand on the surface of Kepler-186f, its star's brightness at noon would appear as bright as our Sun about an hour before sunset on Earth overall. It should be a slightly colder planet with a redder sky. Kepler-186f is located in the Kepler-186 system, approximately 500 light-years from Earth in Cygnus's constellation. The system also hosts four inner planets, seen aligned in orbit around a host star that is half the size and mass of the Sun. Why do we look for exoplanets? An explicit goal of NASA's exoplanet program and all the world's space agencies is to find unmistakable signs of extraterrestrial life. The exoplanet's skies could contain such signs, waiting to be revealed by a detailed analysis of the planet's atmosphere far beyond our solar system. When we analyze the light emitted by a star through the atmosphere of a distant planet using a technique known as transmission spectroscopy, the effect looks like a barcode. The missing cuts in the light spectrum tell us what ingredients are present in the alien atmosphere. One pattern of black spaces could indicate methane, another oxygen, and so on. Seeing them together could be a strong argument in favor of the presence of organic molecules generated by living things. Can we visit exoplanets? Visiting them is not yet possible, since current technology would need to cross enormous distances between the stars. In a previous video about the technologies that extraterrestrials would use to reach the Earth, we talked about some of those technologies we need to travel to other stars. Unfortunately, humanity still does not have any. The ways to know the exoplanets have been from a telescope on Earth or an orbiting satellite that can detect the electromagnetic radiation that reflects or emits the exoplanet to know its chemical composition and size, shape, etc. Are there any upcoming missions to learn more about exoplanets? The Habitable Exoplanet Observatory, HABEX, is a concept for a mission to obtain direct images of planetary systems around Sun-like stars. HABEX will be sensitive to all kinds of planets. However, its primary goal is for the first time to obtain direct images of Earth-like exoplanets and characterize their atmospheric content. By measuring the spectra of these planets, HABEX will look for signs of habitability, such as water, and will be sensitive to gases in the atmosphere that possibly indicates biological activity such as oxygen or ozone. In addition to the search for life on Earth-like exoplanets, HABEX will enable a wide range of general astrophysics, from studying the earliest epochs in the history of the universe to understanding the life cycle and death of the most massive stars, which ultimately supply the elements needed to sustain life as we know it. These studies will be enabled by the same technology that will allow HABEX to study Earth-like planets, a large space-stable telescope with unprecedented resolution that is sensitive to ultraviolet, optical, and near-infrared photons.